chasing all the on that option. Get the mask on my face like a catch. Don't call my phone, it's trying to cop. I pull up and sir, you well.
Yo! Make sure you like, subscribe, and share the show with things like Facebook and Reddit and Instagram and Room.com and wherever else. And guys, the Panthers got a W, so we definitely got to talk about the Panthers getting this win. Secondly, I got to talk about what I seen from this win, what I think about, you know, the Panthers overall, because obviously we got to talk about some things. Some things are looking different than I expected, so we definitely got to talk about that. And I got to give y'all the news about my fantasy. So, a lot of things to talk about today, guys. So let's get started. The first thing I want to talk about is the Panthers got this W over the Arizona Cardinals. And to be honest with you, I'm shocked. I'm surprised. I thought the Panthers would lose this game. Mainly because I thought DeAndre Hopkins was going to run wild, but he did not, which I'm going to get into that. But I'm happy the Panthers got a W, man. They're 2-2 right now. They're third, I think, in the division because they're 0-1. I think the Saints are 1-0, and I think the Bucks are 1-1, and the Bucks are 3-1 for the season, and the Saints are 2-2. So they're third in the division. They're better than the Falcons, which the Falcons are atrocious. Who they play next week? So we're gonna get into that. But I'm happy they got this win, man. The Teddy Bridgewater looked good. Teddy Bridgewater looked very good. He was scrambling. He was doing his best Cam Newton impression, Patrick Mahomes, whatever, Lamar Jackson impression, Michael Vick impression. He was doing his best version of that. So he was scrambling, which was very good for the team. He was throwing the ball well. So I was impressed by that. I was also impressed by the Panthers' O-line. Obviously, Mike Davis was doing his thing. Reggie Bonifant was doing his thing. And it's crazy. The Panthers' O-line is looking really good. It looked good last year, but I think it's a little bit better than last year, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? The running back core, obviously, I think Reggie Bonifant should be ahead of Mike Davis, even though Mike Davis is a power back. I think Reggie Bonifant can get more yards quicker. If he gets a seam, he can take it like 5 to 10 yards easily. I think he's a pretty fast running back. But again, you know, I think two-headed monster, three-headed monster, whatever you want to do, I think that's going to be a good thing for the Panthers. I think Christian McCaffrey is a baller, but his workload is very high. So we'll see if they start limiting that. Obviously, the defense looked great. Brian Burns and Yetur Gross-Matos was doing work. Derrick Brown and Kaywon Short both look good next to each other, so it might save Kaywon Short. But I think he's going to be gone after this year because his cap hit is way too high. Just personally, I think they're going to be like, okay, we could draft another guy with that kind of production and pay him less. So that's how I feel about that. The secondary, Dante Jackson is doing really well. Jeremy Chinn, obviously a linebacker, doing his thing. Shaq Thompson was all over the field. And the Panthers overall look really good. So I'm happy to see that. I'm happy for the Panthers to get these W's. Their schedule gets kind of rough coming up soon. So we'll see how that whole thing plays out. But I ain't gonna lie, Falcons is definitely not rough. So that might be a win for us too. We'll get into that. So the second thing I want to talk about, as happy as I am as the Panthers winning, I got a lot of people in my comment section saying, oh, see, we told you about Teddy Bridgewater. He's a baller, this, that, and the third. And I heard people saying, oh, you know, you was wrong and this, that, and the third, right? I'm happy that the Panthers won, but I got to be honest with y'all. I'm still not sold on Teddy Bridgewater. I'm not sold on the Panthers. I'm happy the Panthers won. People are getting excited about the Panthers winning, but they beat teams that they were supposed to beat. They beat the Chargers with a rookie quarterback who are now 1-3. They beat the Cardinals who lost to the 1-3 Lions and now the 1-2 Panthers before they lost to them. So these teams are not, you know, the top of the league. They're, you know, bottom of the league teams, let's be honest. You know what I'm saying? Or average teams, if anything. Because the Cardinals only beat the Washington Redskins, who obviously don't have a good team. And they barely beat the San Francisco 49ers by 4 points. So I just want people to hold their horses. I want people to slow down because I think people are ready to crown the Panthers as, you know, a good team. But look at the teams they lost to. They lost to the Raiders, who are, I think they're like 2-2 now too. They're 2-2 because they lost to the Bills. And they lost to the Buccaneers, who are now 3-1. They got the Saints coming up, who are 2-2. They got the Chiefs coming up. Chiefs are undefeated. They got the Packers coming up. I think they're undefeated also. They got the Bucks again. They got the Saints again. And The Falcons, yes, they have an atrocious defense, but they have a good offense. And they can put up points. So we'll see how this team looks in a few weeks, because everybody's saying that, oh, you know, the Panthers have arrived, and I don't think the Panthers have. I think the Panthers beat good, bottom of the pack teams. I think they won the games they're supposed to win, and I'm not trying to be negative about the Panthers, but I'm just being realistic. People can't just cry. And then, I know it's two people like, oh, see, they're 2-2. I'm like, my expectations are high because what we had. I got to compare these Panthers to the Panthers of Ron Rivera's era, because they let go of Ron Rivera because they believe that he underachieved. If this team does not win 7-8 games, how are they any better than the Ron Rivera team? Like, Ron Rivera team with the backup quarterback won 5 games. So that's my mindset. I have to compare them to that regime because, again, at the end of the day, they're coming off that regime. They fired him and they let go of their quarterback because they believe that they don't want mediocrity. That's what David Tepper said. He said he don't want mediocrity. So if this team is not mediocre, then if this team is below mediocre or, you know, is not better than mediocre, in my opinion, you made a unilateral move. You just went from one side to the next. So we'll see what the Panthers do. Hopefully they play, you know, saying keep this level of play up and keep on winning games. But I just bracing people for the fall because I don't think that this Panthers team is that good. I think they won 2 games that they should have won and could have won. And you kind of got to, you know, hold your horses and temper your expectations, because at the end of the day, the Panthers, I don't think, are trying to be a great team this year. I think they're trying to get a quarterback, personally. But again, I could be wrong. I don't know their direction. You know what I'm saying? Obviously, they're their organization, but I just don't think that Teddy Bridgewater is a long-term answer, in my opinion. And finally, I got to tell you about my fantasy, man. I took another L. Another 1-point L. It is pissing me off. I'm losing close games. It's bothering me. Like, I would rather get blown out than lose a close game. Close games is like, you just need 1 point, or one, you know what I'm saying? 2 or 3 points from one player or 2 players. Like, Drew Brees gave me 19 instead of 20. If he gave me 20, maybe, or 21, I would probably won this game. So that it stings a little bit more. But I lost. It is what it is. You know what I'm saying? So I'm 2-2 now. I'm like middle of the pack, I guess. But let me tell you my lineup for this week. Obviously, with Cam, and this is subject to change to see how the whole Cam situation with COVID works, because the Patriots play Denver Broncos, and I think Cam's going to run wild if he does play. But we'll see how that whole thing plays out. So my quarterback is Drew Brees, who plays the Chargers, which Tom Brady just threw a party on the Chargers. But who knows? Drew Brees is up and down, so who knows? I got Mike Evans, who's questionable against the Bears. I got Sammy Watkins against the Raiders. We'll see how the whole thing plays out. I got Jonathan Taylor from Indy. I got Devin Singletary. So I traded Mike Williams and Jeff Wilson Jr. for Devin Singletary from the Bills. So now I have in my lineup Devin Singletary from Buffalo. He's in my lineup. I got Hayden Hurst, who couldn't get me 9 points. I lost because the guy I was playing had Todd Gurley, who gave him 19. And he was down by like 18 points. And because Hayden Hurst didn't give me... No, he was down like 11 points. But because Hayden Hurst only gave me 8, and this guy got 19 from him, I lost by 1 point. So it pisses me off, but I got Hayden Hurst starting because I don't got really much tight ends, let's be honest. And then I got Julian Edelman as one of my flex positions, and I got Deebo Samuel as one of my flex positions because now he's finally back. So my bench, I got Atkins from Houston, the tight end, playing against Jacksonville. I don't know if he's healthy. He's been questionable. Who knows? He had a concussion. We'll see how he does with the concussion protocol. I got T. Higgins on my bench because they play Baltimore. I don't trust Cincinnati against Baltimore. I think Baltimore's going to have a field day with them. Cam's on my bench because he has COVID, and we'll see how that whole thing plays out. I have Chris Godwin on my bench because he's still questionable, even though they say he might play. We'll see. The games are kind of close, so he might not play. So that's why I'm leaving him on my bench until I see, you know, that he's actually playing. I got Chase Claypool. I don't think, you know, to start him. He's going against Philly defense. Philly's defense is pretty good. And I got Christian McCaffrey on IR, who should be coming back, I think, next week or the week after. So hopefully he gets back. I got Justin Tucker as my kicker, and I got Indianapolis as my defense. So So far, it says I'm winning, but again, it said I was winning the last 2 weeks too. So we'll see how that whole thing plays out. And hopefully I get a W, man. I'm playing my cousin, so hopefully I get a W. And, you know, y'all stay tuned to see what if I'm 3-2 at the end of next week. Well, that's it for me, guys. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share cool things like Facebook and Reddit and Instagram and wherever else. And, guys, check out the podcast. You know what I'm saying? Obviously, it's getting traction. People are liking it. Definitely check that out. Check out my Anchor account. Obviously, I have the audio for the podcast. If you don't got enough time to watch a video, check out the Anchor account. The Anchor app, whatever it's called, Lights, L, Camera, Action. Definitely check that out. Check out my dog Nasi's channel. Very funny, very talented. Y'all already know what it is. His channel's growing every day. Y'all want to get on the bandwagon now. And, you know, thank y'all for tuning in. Thank y'all for showing love. And I'm going to see y'all next time. Peace.